This Good Morning Northwest morning sprint is brought to you by Bill's Heating and Air Conditioning.
All right, it's 6:53, time to get you ready to take on your Tuesday here in the morning sprint.
It'll be warm today, but a change is coming soon. Mark tells us when that'll happen.
Sydney Charles breaking down some critical debates in two of the closest Wash election campaigns.
But first, let's get to Destiny Richards with some important information you need to know about your ballot if you are registered to vote in Washington.
You'll start to receive your ballots in the mail this week if you're registered. Spokane County Elections Manager Mike McLaughlin says Wednesday and Thursday are when the ballots will start to go out, and voters should expect them in their mailboxes as early as this Friday and Saturday. The most common reason people don't find their ballot in the mail, a change in address. If you don't have your ballot by next Tuesday, a week from today, the Spokane County Elections Office says to check your voter registration status and update your information as needed on votewad.gov. If everything looks okay, but you still don't have a ballot, contact the elections office or visit in person to get a new one.
Hi, Destiny. Thank you very much. In our first alert weather, it is going to be a mild day. Temperatures into the low to mid 70s throughout the region. That extends all the way up to Coeur d'Alene. And then Sandpoint, Bonners Ferry, you're going to be in the low to mid 60s. But everyone else is going to be enjoying some 70 degree weather. It's the 72 hour forecast. That high pressure starts to really press out. And then by Thursday and Friday, we start to see that next system coming in. That's where our big change is going to be. Today, our high today is 72 with 70s in the afternoon.
A driver in Northwest Spokane hit a child as they were crossing the street. It happened near Northwest Boulevard and Driscoll last night. Officers tell us the child is in the hospital. The driver was not arrested.
The application to get up to $20,000 in federal student loan forgiveness is now open. President Biden made the announcement yesterday, adding Republicans are the only thing standing in the way of millions receiving relief. To apply, just go to the website studentaid.gov.
We have new developments in a story involving contaminated drinking water linked to Fairchild Air Force Base. Those chemicals, known as PFAS, have contaminated water for many people who live near the base. PFAS were part of a fire-extinguishing foam used by military bases across the country. Over time, these chemicals leaked into the soil and down into the water. The Air Force has continued testing water in this region, supplying water and filtration systems to those over the lifetime health advisory limit. That's where the level is no longer safe to drink the water.
A new study shows water, air, and heavy metal pollution is a leading cause of death that often gets overlooked. An international team of scientists finds pollution has a greater impact on our health than malaria, HIV, drugs, or alcohol. And pollution is the number one environmental risk for disease and mortality. You can see all of our past coverage about water contamination in Airway Heights right now on KXLY.com.
And the candidates from last night's races got personal, taking on issues from abortion to immigration. In the Ohio race, Democrat Tim Ryan is locked in a tight race against Trump-backed Republican candidate J.D. Vance. Last night in their final debate, Ryan accused Vance of pushing racist belief. Vance called that claim false. And last night in Georgia, where early voting has already begun, Governor Brian Kemp faced his Democratic rival, Stacey Abrams. The candidates sparred over crime and abortion. Coverages on the crucial races will continue on Good Morning America.
Phase three of the Riverside Avenue construction project has that street closed between Wall and Stevens, so people are searching for ways to navigate around it. Stevens is also down one lane at Spokane Falls Boulevard heading south. And over on Washington Street, there's a single lane closure starting at Riverside. This final phase of the project should last about 7 weeks. When it's all said and done, it'll change the lane structure and add a bike lane.
A household appliance you use regularly could cause a devastating fire. It's your clothes dryer. According to the Spokane Fire Department, more than 16,000 dryer fires happen every year across the country. Checking the dryer vent often can reduce fire risk. Spokane's fire chief says it's important to remove buildup by disconnecting and vacuuming the inside of the vent. People should check the dryer vent at least, he says, once a month.
The New America Skate Ribbon won't open until mid-November, but now is the time to get your unlimited ice pass. Not only does it grant you unlimited access to ice skating, but you get 15% off at the Sky Ribbon Cafe and Riverfront Gifts, 4 tickets to the Louvre Carousel, and 1 single-use admission ticket and skate rental for a friend. The new FDA ruling allows over-the-counter hearing aids to be more accessible and more affordable to the general public. Experts urge anyone with questions to get in touch with an audiologist for guidance. Walmart has already announced it will sell the devices. They'll cost between $200 to $1,000 per pair. We'll get his final check of the weather with Mark. It tells us how long this smoke and haze will stick around next.